Get no party, don't stop the party. Get no party, don't stop the party.
No. This year we are staying in because obviously there's a pandemic and we are socially distancing. So while I was incredibly excited to celebrate my Friday the 13th birthday this year, the world had other plans. You know, last year around my birthday, I was feeling kind of down. I was thinking about death and how it was 1 year less that I get to live, and how it was like, oh, it's 1 year less, like 1 year closer to my death. And I kind of went that route mentally initially, but this year had other plans for me and a lot growing to do. And as a result, I ended up with amazing perspective and a far better attitude than I had last year around my birthday. Because I'm usually super excited about my birthday. I don't know what happened last year, but I'm glad that I went through all the growth that I had to do and I'm here, alive. Celebrating in my room. So I want to share with you these 5 things that I learned from this year, my 27th year of living, 2020, which was insane. But before I get into it, I want to remind you to subscribe to this channel, like this video, and leave a comment down below. This tells me that, hey, you appreciate my work, that, hey, it's kind of like a free gift that you can give me for my birthday. Absolutely free. You don't have to pay anything. It's just a couple clicks. Ding, 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 and that's it. Anywho, let's get started. The number one thing that I learned this year was to be brave. Maybe you learned that too, because this year has been incredibly challenging. And it's funny because I started this year kind of in a challenging way. We were in Joshua Tree, which is a national park in California, and it's like this huge desert with big, big rocks that you get to climb and just boulder around. And I've never done anything like that in my life, but for some reason, I was there and it was presented to me. So I said, okay, we're doing this. And I ended up climbing, I don't even know how much, but it was so, so much, hours and hours to go up to the top. And there were times where I was incredibly afraid. I would look down and I would see a long, long fall, maybe hundreds of feet down. And I would look and I was like, all right, if I fall, I'm gonna die. And my mom is gonna kill me if I die here. So I better, you know, put that fear aside and make sure I'm stepping on the right place and I'm moving forward. And that attitude took me all the way to the top, where I was able to see incredible, beautiful views, amazing things, so, 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 so cool. I wouldn't change it for a bit. So that's the kind of energy that I was in when I was walking into 2020, because that was January. And I was like, you know what? Whatever happens this year, it's not gonna be as scary as being on that mountain, on that giant rock, climbing and looking down and realizing that I could fall and die. So with everything else that happened this year, I just kept pushing through and pushing through fear and saying, you know what? I'm gonna keep going because it's gonna be worth it and it's gonna be amazing. And quite honestly, it was. This year was incredibly weird. It was odd, but I definitely got a lot out of it, especially with being with my family and being in my country and being in my home. It was something that I really appreciated for this whole time. Number two, second thing that I learned this year was to trust my abilities. Whenever I was faced with challenges this year, I had to look inside of me and say, you know what? I have everything I need to face this right here, right now. And I did. And if I didn't know something back then, I learned it in the process, and that was part of my growth. This also taught me that I could go through life my own way. I could do it in my style. I didn't have to change or pretend to be somebody else in order to be taken seriously. I just had to do it my way and show up and bring all of my abilities and my skills to the table, because we all have different abilities and skills, and we all bring something different to the table, and you can only bring it, like, it can only be brought by you. So you gotta do it your own way, you gotta do it your own style, and you gotta just have fun through it. That's the most important thing in life, if you haven't learned that already. The third thing that I learned this year was to stay in my lane, to not look to the left or to the right and look at what everybody else is doing and compare myself to them. No. I can't go forward if I'm looking to my sides. And this really helped me to fall in complete love with my mission, with my path, with my story, with my movie, because it's different from you and yours is different from mine. And you have to witness yours, I have to witness mine, so I'm gonna make sure I freaking love my path and I'm enjoying it and I'm having fun and I'm looking at it and looking at the things that are happening in my life and being just amazed, like, oh my gosh, this is awesome. This also taught me to appreciate other people's path and to respect them. I don't need to intervene in anybody's life. I don't need to change anybody's life, especially my loved ones. I just need to be a witness to their growth, be happy for their wins, be there for them, support them, give them my solicited advice when they need it, when they ask for it, and make sure that I'm just witnessing and observing their growth, because they have their path, I have my path, and they cross and they intertwine, and that's all they need to do. I don't need to go ahead and change your path because I think you're doing something wrong, or because this or that, or because I learned something before you learned something. You are gonna learn that same thing at your own time, in your own moment. And I don't wanna cheat you from that lesson, so I'm not gonna tell you, hey, you need to do this, you need to do that. No, you need to follow your own inner guidance and allow that to take you through life to every single lesson that you're meant to learn. And that is something that I learned, that I just gotta let things be and let people be. The fourth thing that I learned this year was that consistency really pays off. I have never truly been known for my consistency, be it that I start something and then I start something else and I start something else. And it's not a negative trait, because it allows me to learn different things and explore, experience different things. And once I get them, I tend to get bored because I do learn pretty fast. But there is power in consistency. For example, I've been really consistent with my workouts and I am really happy with what I'm doing for my body, with the progress I'm seeing, with the strength I'm gaining. It's been an amazing path, and this is something that I want to keep up. Same with my YouTube. This is my fifth week uploading 2 videos a week, and it feels good to look back and look at all the videos that I've made and how everyone has something to do with the other, and think about what I'm gonna do next and how am I gonna do my makeup, because I have been doing some crazy things over here. I don't know if you've noticed, but I've been having a lot of fun setting everything up. There's a green screen behind me that has to be perfectly straight and no wrinkles, and it takes me about 3 hours to get the right results, but the whole process is a lot of fun and I'm having fun with it, and I wanna keep being consistent with it. So come back every week and see if I keep it up. I read a quote similar to this on a little tea bag, and it says, if you want to expect good, create a sequence of good, something like that. Or like, if you create a sequence of good, you can expect good things. I can't remember what it was exactly, but it speaks of consistency, and I'm implementing that a little bit more and more in my life. So I think you can do it as well. Whatever it means to you to be consistent in whatever area of your life, try it. Try it for a few and then keep trying it for a few more. And the fifth lesson that I have picked up this year has been to be grateful. Gratitude. I can find gratitude in any situation I'm in. If I can do certain things, if I can't do certain things, if I'm in a certain place, if I'm not in a certain place, if I'm with a certain people, if I'm not with certain people, whatever it is, I know that I can always find a reason to be grateful in the present moment that I'm experiencing. And through practicing that this year, this has been an incredible year. I've grown my family bonds so much. I've become closer with my mother than I've ever had, and it's the greatest gift. It truly, truly is. So even though it's been a crazy year and it's not been what we all expected, I can truly honestly say that I am grateful for this year and for everything that came with it and everyone that was part of it in one way or another, because there is always a reason to be grateful for, and as long as I can find a reason to be grateful for, I know I'm gonna be okay. Because whenever you start looking around and you start noticing reasons that you got to be grateful for, you're just gonna attract more, and you're just gonna have more of those reasons pop up in your life. So why not practice gratitude? It's so easy, and you can really change your life through it. Well, that is all for today. I want to thank you so much for being here. Thank you for watching this whole thing if you did. I hope you enjoyed this Friday the 13th as much as I do, because I was born on one of these Friday the 13ths, and they are very, very fun and very, very exciting. So I hope you enjoy yours. Make sure you leave a comment. What was your favorite part of the video? If you have any thoughts, you can share them. Or if you wanna make any suggestions of what you wanna see in this channel, in this space, you are more than welcome, so just type them down below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, follow me on my socials, and take care. I love you so much. Mwah!